Quick question. Do you know which Japanese filmmaker is often considered to be the best of all time? Well, yeah, he is one of them, but do you know another one? Huh, I guess there are some really great Japanese filmmakers. Huh.
Yasujirō Ozu's Tokyo Story is one of the great movies. No ifs, ands, or buts about it, and none of the usual disqualifiers of, oh, it's a great film for a Japanese film, or it's great for a foreign language film, or none of that bullshit that we Westerners tend to make that separate foreign movies into its own category, because they can't possibly be as good as films made in Hollywood.
To which I say, fuck that noise, lick my butt.
Tokyo Story is a flat-out great movie. It's easily one of the most influential films of all time and is often on many critics' greatest movies lists, up there with Vertigo, Citizen Kane, and 2001 A Space Odyssey.
What I'm trying to say is that the film is an elite company.
The key to Tokyo Story's greatness is in how its story is universal. The plot follows an elderly couple traveling to Tokyo to visit their children, grandchildren, and their respective families, only to be met with indifference by virtue of their kids being too busy with their careers and their own families, tragically taking their parents for granted, assuming that their parents will always be there and they'll see them some other time.
One of the children describes why this is problematic in very stark terms. Yeah, it's kind of sad.
As I said, the story resonates with so many people because it's so relatable to basically any culture. Never mind that this is a black and white foreign language film from 1953, and forget how this takes place in a different culture where beds are never used, chairs are rarely sat in, and everyone has their own personal fan to keep on themselves in order to deal with excessive heat or someone passing gas indiscriminately.
Sorry, I couldn't resist.
The point of the story is, unless you found the Fountain of Youth, getting old and dying are themes that are applicable to everyone, especially those of us who already have kids, because then you have to watch them get old too, which then inevitably causes us to ponder if we were good parents, if we were successful, if our kids are successful, and if we raised them right.
Or your kids could have a free tongue and be unafraid of insulting you.
Ah.
You know, the whole point of a your mama's so fat joke is to make fun of other people's mothers. Not your own!
However, the movie is not entirely doom and gloom. There is a lot of joy to be had, particularly from the great performances by Shishu Ryu as Shukichi Hirayama and his wife Tami Hirayama, played by Chieko Higashiyama.
I probably messed up the pronunciation of those names, but they don't call me Riley the Butcherer of Names for no reason.
Despite the absolutely downer themes of this movie, the elderly couple accepts everything so matter-of-factly with grace and humility. The scenes with the two of them together exchanging banter about their more youthful days is quite heartwarming, especially when they meet with the children who really do mean well, even if those little shits are too busy, and they ensure that their parents have a good time in the grand city of Tokyo.
It emphasizes the fact that there's still joy to be life and had, even though we understand that life is cyclical in the fact that we born, we grow up, we have kids of our own, they grow up, we die, and then they eventually die. Everything's pointless, but it's fine. It's fine, there's still good things in life. Which is a point that's emphasized later in the movie when the elderly couple talks to some strangers in order to talk about their own children. To which they think they are a bunch of fuck-ups. This movie reaffirms my belief that we will all get old and eventually complain about young people.
しかしな、沼田さん。わしも今度出てくるまじゃ、もちっとせがれがどうにかなっとると思うとりました。
ところがあんた、まずいのこう、まい町医者でさ。あんたの言うことはよ、わかる。あんたの言うように、わしも不満じゃ。じゃがの、沼田さん。これは世の中の親っちゅうもんの欲じゃ。欲があったらキリがない。これは諦めにゃならん。と、そうわしは思うたんじゃ。
思うたか。
思うたか。
そうか。あんたもな。
あれもあんなやつじゃなかったんじゃが。しょうがないわい。
This guy gets it.
Additional to being a meditative study on life and death, it is definitely worth noting the impressive filmmaking on display by Ozu. By the time Tokyo Story came to be in 1953, the man had been perfecting his craft for over 2.5 decades, and it definitely shows in Tokyo Story. Shots are framed and actors are spaced in a way that we can often see through an entire house or hallway, watching motion in the foreground, midground, and background. Despite all the activity on screen, there is always a focus where the eye is drawn to, so we don't miss any story beats. And that's really impressive because moods of a scene can change as we witness a character move about across the frame, changing the tone of a sequence from a lighthearted comedic scene to a more darker one, or vice versa.
また今度な。
ゆえ
何みのる。
あっち行ってらっしゃい。
何で嘘つき。
あっち行ってらっしゃい。
おいで。
やだよ。本当にしょうがあります。
いやあ、男の子は元気な方がええよ。
Not throwing objects at your grandparents!
By the end, which I won't spoil for you even though this movie has been out for 65 years, the conclusion embodies the themes built up throughout the entire movie in a perfectly sobering manner, and you will find that Tokyo Story speaks to the universal life experience of getting old and dying, but also of acceptance and kind of being okay with it.
If you're a parent, you've probably found yourself wondering, you know, will my kids be a bunch of fuck-ups? Will they be okay? Did I do well? What will they think of me when I'm gone?
The movie asks this as well because it wants to remind us kids to spend time and love our parents and respect them while they are still here. And that's a point that needs to be repeated to people over and over again because inevitably, no one lasts forever, so don't put off seeing your loved ones because for all you know, there might not be some other time.
And that's the hopeful element of the movie. We can still see the people that are still with us. We don't have to take them for granted. And this is an idea that spans across all aspects of life, and is one of the many reasons as to why Tokyo Story is regarded as one of the greatest movies of all time. I give Ozu's Tokyo Story a 5 out of 5. See you next time.